Hello and welcome to this video where I will tell you a bit more about the important topic of cybersecurity. We will explore the NIS2 Directive and the Cyber Resilience Act and understand why you and your company need to be focused on it. Cybersecurity is about keeping systems, networks, and programs safe from digital attacks. These attacks usually try to steal, change, or destroy sensitive information. They can also demand money through ransomware or disrupt business operations. The topic of cybersecurity is not a new one. It has been around for many years, but it has become a bigger and bigger part of everyday life. Now, when there are more devices than people and attackers are getting more creative, it becomes more difficult to ensure strong cybersecurity. When people think about cybersecurity, they tend to think about the critical infrastructure of a country. This consists of various sectors like public companies, utilities, defense companies, or something along those lines. But more sectors are affected. For example, imagine a food and beverage company where the conveyor belts aren't running because of a cyber attack. Or think about an electric ferry that needs to recharge, but the charger isn't working because of a cyber attack. You need to be focused on cybersecurity because all sectors can be affected. On a global scale, cybersecurity is also becoming more and more important. The European Union has developed a high-level strategy to become more cyber resilient. This resulted in the introduction of both the NIS2 Directive and the Cyber Resilience Act. I will first dive a bit more into the NIS2. Here, it is important to distinguish between IT and OT. IT is information technology and it handles data. OT, or operation technology, handles something in the physical world. An example of IT is a server that stores documentation. OT could be a controller that controls the speed of a conveyor belt. When talking about critical infrastructure within OT, we are referring to essential entities such as food, energy, transportation, health, digital infrastructure, and more. Manufacturers of electronics are also affected by this directive and are categorized as important entities. The Cyber Resilience Act from the EU is aimed at strengthening the cybersecurity and resilience of digital products and services within the EU. The Act basically seeks to ensure that products with digital elements, which includes hardware and software, are designed and maintained with robust cybersecurity measures throughout their lifecycle. There are some key aspects covered by the Cyber Resilience Act. The Cyber Resiliency Act is expected to get final approval in the EU in the first quarter of 2025. According to the new rules, the owner of the installation, also known as the asset owner, is responsible for ensuring that an installation is resilient towards attacks from outside. The owner needs to specify measures and security levels. The technical details are described by the IEC 62443. It presents a process to identify the so-called security level which is needed, and also it guides on how to achieve the needed security level for protecting the installation. To achieve the cybersecurity certification and comply with the future new rules, Danfoss meticulously documents all processes from development to production. This includes purchasing components, developing software, creating software tools, and managing production processes. These processes are continuously audited to ensure no security threats are introduced. Additionally, each product is thoroughly examined to identify potential threats. For every identified threat, we develop mitigation measures either through software solutions or special cyber chips, which prevent unauthorized access or tampering with the installed software. When Danfoss delivers a product, we have done our utmost to protect your installation, but still keep the product easy to use. If your installation is not impacted, you are able to utilize our product as you have always done. But we still want you to know that our products are designed to be cyber secure. Danfoss AC drives are primarily used in operational technology, which means they control physical processes. Because of this, Danfoss has chosen to use the requirements from the IEC 62443 standard to implement and certify products in scope for cybersecurity. The requirements cover various topics such as technical requirements for control systems, where the drives are subcomponents, then product development lifecycle processes, and technical requirements for components. The new cybersecurity rules are expected to start taking effect from 2024 to 2026. Companies within critical infrastructure will need to comply by October 18, 2024. And within marine industry, this will be needed by the 1st of August, 2024. During 2024, Danfoss drives will comply with these requirements. Danfoss VLT drives that fall under this scope will follow the process rules of IEC 62443 Part 4 1 and the component guidelines from Part 4 2. They will meet security level 1. These products are scheduled to receive cybersecurity certification from TÜV during 2024. Danfoss can also help you to achieve system certification according to standards like IEC 62443 Part 3 3 and other cybersecurity standards. We offer mitigation solutions at the system level, focusing on how VLT drives interact with other components, such as PLCs, to ensure that the overall system meets cybersecurity requirements. Thank you for joining me in exploring the critical topic of cybersecurity, including insights into NIS 2 Directive and the Cyber Resilience Act. It's clear that safeguarding your system from digital threats is more important than ever. As I've explained, these new regulations will impact various sectors, emphasizing the need for robust cybersecurity measures across industries like water, energy, and beyond. Whether you are involved in critical infrastructure or not, understanding these standards is essential. At Danfoss, we are committed to deliver products that meet the highest cybersecurity standards and make sure that your installations remain secure and operational. Our adherence to certifications like IEC 62443 underscores our dedication to protect your systems. If you found this video informative, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more updates from Danfoss. Visit our website for further details on how we can assist you in achieving cybersecurity compliance by following the link in the description of this video. Thank you once again and stay secure.